Well, what started out as a simple and calm day in the county of Kent in the United Kingdom suddenly transformed into a calamitous shunning as a group of cruise passengers turned against one of their own for a seemingly simple mistake. Anybody enjoy an uncomfortable bus ride? No, not me. But that's what it was. Cruisers can be mean. Let's talk about it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to La Lido Loca. I am your host, Tony, here with a bit of a story time, a cautionary tale from the town of Canterbury, where famously Geoffrey wrote his tales. This is a tale of woe in the form of a cruise excursion. Let me set the stage for you. The day started off wonderfully as we sailed in past the majestic white cliffs of Dover. My goal that day, along with tens of others, was to excursion on a bus out to Leeds Castle, and then spend some time in Canterbury, and then see the sights in the county of Kent. And well, that's what we proceeded to do. After gathering together in the World Theater, we made our way to our motor coach, and we proceeded 45 minutes away from the city of Dover, deep into the county, to the castle known as Leeds. Now, unfortunately, if you did not read the fine print of this excursion, you were quickly faced with the fact that to get to said Leeds Castle, you had to first traverse a 15-minute walk through the gardens to get there. The first 10 minutes, you never even saw the castle. It was a hike. I just want to say that, and it said it right there in the brochure. So really no surprises were to be had. But yes, many people disembarking our motor coach were faced with the fact that it was going to be a bit of a walk. Now, we arrived at the entrance of the Leeds Castle at 11 a.m. We were instructed to be back on the motor coach by 12:15 p.m. So that meant if you wanted to make the hike to the Leeds Castle, you really had to get your feet a step in because of the aforementioned around 15-minute walk to get to the castle. And we all embarked and went on our merry way, and we saw some spectacular sights. The stroll through the gardens and the tour of the Leeds Castle, it was definitely something to behold. A throwback to a time of opulence, when fancy people lived fancily in fancy places with fancy things, with fancy names. Names that have slipped my mind at this point, but I know the castle was called Leeds. So all was well. I navigated the gardens, I explored the castle, I reverse navigated the gardens, and I got myself back on the bus at about 12:05 p.m., and the bus was about 75% full. Well, as you can imagine, 10 minutes later, the bus was, well, it wasn't 100% full, it was 99% full. We were missing one lone passenger. 12:15 became 12:20, and 12:20 became 12:25, and the tour guide, he started to look a little bit concerned. He got on the phone with his boss, saying that he's counted and recounted multiple times, and he's missing one person, and he doesn't see that person anywhere in his sight. What should they do? And upon hearing this phone conversation, a small group of people in the bus were like, "You should just leave the person." And I was like, wow, this is going to be interesting. And of course, the tour guide said, no, we're not going to leave the person. And just a short, 7 or 8 minutes later, an older woman came hobbling. You know, her mobility was a little challenged. She came hobbling back to the bus. And when I say older woman, older than me, definitely looked like somebody's grandma. And she, you know, was making her way back from that walk from the castle, which again, until you walked it, you did not know exactly what that walk was. And so, yeah, she misjudged the time and she got back 15, 20 minutes late. And the people on the bus weren't happy. One lady that was sitting near me, she was saying loudly, "This is why I don't do these excursions, because you can't trust other people to be on time." And then there was a grumbling behind me. And when the lady boarded the bus, much to my surprise, the grumbling behind me became audible words. And there was a man who started shouting, "TikTok! TikTok! TikTok!" And the lady did the walk of shame past that TikToking man and took her seat in the back of the bus. And well, the story could have ended there, but it did not, because the seeds of chaos had been planted. had been planted and more water would be poured on the seeds of chaos. And to be fair, the tour guide did his best to abate the chaos by saying, wow, we have extra time packed in the schedule. We're going to get to our next stop, which is Canterbury, on time. We're going to be right on time. No big deal that this lady was late back to the coach. But again, like I said, the seeds of chaos had been planted. We made our way from Leeds Castle about 45 minutes to Canterbury. Canterbury, home of the Canterbury Cathedral, the Archbishop of Canterbury. He's got a job coming up where he will coronate the king very soon. Important dude there in Canterbury. And of course, the inspiration for Geoffrey Chaucer's Canterbury Tales. And our goal was to spend the next 2 hours adventuring, exploring High Street there in Canterbury, seeing the sights, finding the old Norman wall. Interestingly, as we arrived to Canterbury, the tour director had changed his tune a little bit, apparently not because of the woman, but other circumstances. We had arrived to Canterbury a little late. The traffic was a little heavy, and he said, well, we're about a half hour behind now, so instead of leaving at 3 like I had planned from Canterbury, I want to give you guys the full 2 hours. We will leave at 3:30. And so off the coach I went. I explored High Street, all the while unawares of the chaos that was brewing. And so in my naivete, I arrived back at the bus stop. It was about 20 minutes before our assigned meeting time. The bus wasn't even there. This is one of those bus depots where the bus has to get in and out quickly. They can't hang around. They can't pick up passengers. It's got to happen all at once. I arrived there about 20 minutes early. And as I walked up upon a group of my fellow adventurers, one of the ladies there was recounting to some strangers the account of why we were late to Canterbury. We should have been here earlier, but there was a lady who was late back to the bus at Leeds Castle. She seemed unaware of what time she was supposed to be there, and we all had to wait for her, and that's why we are late right now. And while technically we were late, it's not like we were even close to the all aboard time for the cruise ship. But the interesting thing in this part of the story is while she was complaining about that lady, two strangers from another tour group, that lady walked up upon her. And while in most social circumstances, you would think that when the person that you're talking about walks up upon you, you'd stop talking about the person, she did not. She identified this lady to the other people that this was the lady. This was the lady that was late. And I think she was doing it to kind of incentivize the lady to be on time for this bus. And well, her technique, it did not work. The lady who was late for the first bus stood there for 5 minutes talking to the lady who was complaining about her. And then she had a bright idea. With just 10 minutes before the bus was to arrive, she decided there was a store that she had not visited yet. And she proceeds to leave the bus area to go and do further shopping. You know who didn't take that action very well? The lady that was talking bad about her. As soon as she got out of earshot, she starts laying in. I can't believe this lady is going shopping. If she's late for this bus, I'm going to tell the bus driver to leave her. And some lady was like, oh, you know, maybe she's just trying to figure out her way. This is a new... No, this is irresponsible. I've never seen anything so irresponsible. I was just taking it all in. I'd never seen so much human drama unfolding in front of me over a bus check-in time. Like I said, the seeds of chaos had been planted, and of course now it's been watered. And fortunately, the lady was in and out of whatever store she went looking at within like 5 minutes. She was back. She was back ready to board the bus. Everyone boarded the bus at 3:30 at the appropriate time. And then... this happened. The tour guide said, in the brochure, in the description of this tour, we promised you Leeds Castle, we promised you Canterbury, and we also promised to show you some of the sites in the county of Kent. And well, because of, you know, legal obligations, that promise has to be kept. So we're going to take the long way back to Dover. We're going to take the long way home. And I was excited about it because I knew that one of the places we were going to go was Sandwich, where the Earl of Sandwich was from, where sandwiches were created, and I was excited about that. But interestingly, taking the temperature of the bus, I feel like I was in the minority of the going to the town of Sandwich excitement. As soon as we took off from the bus depot in Canterbury, the murmuring began. I heard people saying, this is a long day. I got a 5 o'clock dinner reservation. And people started saying it a little louder and a little louder until it got to the tour guide's ears. And this tour guide was a really great tour guide, English gentleman. And so I couldn't do any justice to his response. But essentially he said, look, we have to keep a certain schedule to get you back to the ship at a certain time so that you do not miss the ship. Beyond that, we have a lot of leeway, and it is up to me to deliver what was promised in the tour, and well, that's what we're doing. And it was at that point, somebody close to the front said, look, I've got dinner at 5 o'clock. You have to get me back there sooner. And the guy was like, okay, sorry, we'll be there when we get there. So by the time we got back to Dover, it was an interesting mix of tired and angry people, angry at the late woman, angry at the bus driver, and well, it was a beautiful drive through the countryside of Kent, and we saw where the Earl of Sandwich, asked for roast beef between bread. We saw some wonderful other sights, but I don't know what happened. So what say ye if you found yourself on the road to Canterbury and one desperate traveler found themselves lagging behind? Would you be the voice of anger or would you be the voice of compassion? Who's right? Who's wrong in this situation? And have you ever seen anybody go crazy for seemingly no reason at all? I would love to hear about that. Leave a comment below. Thanks so much for checking the show out today. This is Tony for La Lido Loca, and until the next time, we'll see ye in Canterbury! Or on the Lido.